Okay, hey, it's Nicole, Body by You Fitness. So every Thanksgiving, we screw up. Every holiday time, we screw up. We're like, oh, I'm not gonna eat anything because it's Thanksgiving. Or, oh, I'm not gonna eat anything because it's Hanukkah or Christmas or Kwanzaa or freaking holiday you celebrate. And you don't eat anything because you wanna eat everything. You can't not eat anything because when you don't eat, you end up consuming more calories, then you feel bad about yourself, and it's this downward spiral, and it's all super horrible. So, eat like you normally eat. And then when it comes to Thanksgiving dinner, make good choices. Have turkey, have stuffing, have bread, have whatever you want to have, but just have it in moderation. And a good rule of thumb is to slow the heck down. So slow down. So eat slower. Chew your food. Drink a huge glass of water before you eat. Try not to drink while you eat because drinking tends to get in the way of digestion, can cause all sorts of gastrointestinal upset. So try not to drink, you know, water and stuff like that while you eat. And for sure, if you're super concerned about wanting to eat a lot of food, don't waste extra calories on your drinks. So stay away from soda, stay away from juice, keep your alcoholic beverages to a minimum. And if you're gonna choose alcohol, choose wisely. Listen, there's this really cool thing, it's called Google. I know it's crazy, you've probably never heard of it, but you can actually Google stuff and find out nutritional information. Because once you know something, you can't unknow it. So ignorance is not bliss when you're trying to be fit and healthy, so don't make that mistake. So, and then the other thing is I wanted to give you guys a workout. One of my clients asked me for a workout for Thanksgiving because she's gonna be out of town and I thought I would share it with you. So I'm not gonna do it in real time with you because I just finished training myself, but I'm gonna give you all the exercises. It's a 300 rep challenge and you don't need any equipment except for your body and maybe like an ottoman or a chair or two, things that you already have handy. So just make sure that you warm up first and always make sure that you cool down and that you stretch when you're done. Don't stretch with a cold body, you'll snap a muscle easily. So warm up with something, you know, ballistic, some jumping jacks, some squats, some lunges, some ballistic stretching where you're stretching but you're moving, and then cool down with some static stretchings, meaning stretches where you hold for about 30 seconds at a time. Take some deep breaths and let's go. 300 reps challenge. Everything you have for the all repetitions, little to no rest. It should only take you, I don't know, maybe 15 minutes, and you can extend the workout actually by, if you have a jump rope, in between each group of exercises, set a timer on your phone and jump rope for 60 seconds. So if you want to do that and take this more into a HIIT workout, then you can do that. Otherwise, just make it through all these repetitions as quickly as possible. We're gonna try and hit every muscle group, okay? So get yourself two chairs, or if you only have one, fine, one is fine, and have it handy, a bottle of water, and warm up. I'll meet you back here in a minute. Okay, so first exercise is high knees. This is not high knees, this is cheating. So high knees, you wanna get your knees at least to your waist if you can get it above your belly button, awesome. And you're gonna do 30. So right, left, right, left, right, left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. So one, until you get to 30, super easy. Next exercise is mountain climbers. Mountain climbers, you wanna be in a perfect plank. So when you do a mountain climber, you don't wanna push the floor away from you. You wanna barely touch your toes to the floor, pull your shoulders back and down, have your head nice and long, and you wanna pull. So there's a slight round to your back, you're pulling your belly button, your spine, and you're getting your feet as close to your hands as possible. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the way until 30. So pull, don't push. Next exercise, deep squats. Deep squats means you gotta get your butt down. So you're gonna put your feet shoulder distance apart. Slight turn to your toes. I mean, like generally speaking, your toes should face forward when you're not lifting heavy. So about a 10 degree turnout, maybe 20. Shoulder distance apart. Inhale as you go down, exhale as you push up. If squatting is new to you and you don't have a lot of flexibility, shift the weight to your heels, lift the toes in your shoes,
once you get familiar with it, you want to actually push through all four corners of your feet and push the ground away from you. So as you go down, you're going to inhale. As you come up, you're going to exhale. If you can, you're going to drop your butt below parallel. So you're going to come all the way down, all the way up, just moving vertical. So you're going to do 30 of these as fast as you can. When you come up, don't hyperextend. You want to come up and squeeze your lats, your back, your glutes, your abs, everything, belly to your spine. So 30 deep squats. You are doing 15 decline push-ups. So you're going to get that bench or that chair. You're going to put your feet on the bench, the chair, the coffee table, whatever it is, and you're going to pull your shoulders back and down, and you're going to get your chest as close to the floor as possible. Don't dip your butt, and don't put your butt straight in the air, because we're not doing pike push-ups, we're doing just regular old push-ups. So belly is tight, spread your fingers wide, chest to the ground, and then come up. After this one, so 30 of those, 30 of those? Just kidding, 15 of those to learn how to add. So 15 decline push-ups. Next one is 30 elevated dips. If you have two chairs, pull them together. If not, I'll give you a modification. So you're gonna put your feet on the bench, shoulders back and down, hands are really close to your glutes, your belly's tight, and you're gonna get down as low as you can and push straight up. Belly's in. If you don't have a bench, a second bench, then you're just gonna put your feet straight out, keeping your back close to the bench and squeezing your triceps every time. So 30 dips. Next one is a tuck jump. Basically, you wanna get your knees as close to your chest as possible. So you're gonna come down, you're gonna inhale, and then jump as high as you can. So inhale, really pull up, it's coming from your core. Getting out of the shot. You can touch, you can put your hands straight out, but you wanna keep a neutral spine all the time. You're gonna do 30 of those. You're gonna land super light. Burpees. Everybody loves burpees, said nobody ever. This particular burpee, you're only gonna do 15. If you can land in the push-up, winning. Your goal is to go as quickly through these exercises as possible without rest, very little to no rest. So, I'll do it from the side so you can see. So, as you come down, lock your body out into a nice perfect plank. So your back's gonna be flat. Don't come down like this, your belly comes out, you compromise your back. So shoulders back and down. Come down, lock into the plank, but don't rest here. You wanna end up in the actual push-up. So if you're gonna end up in the actual push-up, as you jump down, go into the push-up. So come down into the push-up, jump in, jump up. Come down into the push-up, jump in, jump up. 15. We're almost done. 30 plank shoulder taps. This is another super tricky one. You wanna actually engage your core. In order to do that, you have to be shoulder over wrist, keep your feet together, and don't let your hips move. So when you're in this plank, pull your shoulders back and down. Tap, 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 tap. Don't lift your butt up, don't let it sink, and certainly don't do this. Keep your body strictly locked. Straight body line, ears, shoulders, hips, knees, ankles all the time. So keep your shoulders above your wrists, keep your glutes locked in, and keep your toes light, and just tap. So 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 30. If you wanna make that harder, put your feet on the bench, in decline, 30 taps. If you wanna make it even harder, you can do handstand shoulder taps up against the wall. You choose your own adventure. Last one, 30 crab toe touches. So you're gonna sit, actually, that's not the last one. I lied. We've got abs and lunges. Whoopsie daisies. Okay, So first one is 30 jackknife abs. So you're lying flat. Your hands are behind you and they touch. You're gonna come all the way up and get your ribs to your thighs. So you're gonna inhale as you come down. Exhale as you come up. Inhale. Exhale. Don't slam on the ground and really, really try and get your ribs as close to your thighs as possible. So look up, don't look through. Good? Good. 30 of those. Next one, 30 lunges. This is not a jump lunge. I know you might think it is, but your goal in a jump lunge is to get your knee as close to the ground, if not to the ground. You don't want to crack your knee open, but you definitely want to get it close. If you need to swing your arms, swing your arms. But you're going to start down, switch. And you want to get that knee as close to the ground as possible. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. So think up, not over. Final crab toe touch. Totally, I forgot that one. So you're gonna be in a crab position. You're gonna pick your glutes off the ground. You're gonna reach for your opposite foot. Don't let your butt fall down. Your goal is to pull your belly to your spine and keep it up. 2, 3, 4, 5, until you get to 30. So that's 300 reps. Did I forget any? I think I'm good. So most importantly, focus on your form. Drink water. Again, if you want to turn this up a notch and really get your heart rate going, every time you finish one exercise, jump rope 60 seconds. Jump rope with your knees high. Make sure when you're done, you cool down. Take some deep breaths. Exhale. Whatever it is that you have to do to cool your body down, and then stretch. And every time you stretch, try and deepen and surrender into whatever stretch that you're holding. Dude, no excuses. You don't need any equipment. All you need is you. That's it. It's so much easier than you think. It's so much easier. Give yourself a little credit. Give yourself permission to be amazing. Be the absolute best version of yourself. Stop torturing yourself with food and all of this workout stuff. It doesn't have to be hard. It can be as simple as you make it. You have the power to control every bit that happens in your life. Everything. Everything. How you respond to every situation, how you react, how you choose to execute your workout, how you choose to eat. None of that stuff has control over you. Nobody's holding a gun to your head and telling you have to eat more turkey. If you're hungry, eat. If you're not, stop. That's it, it's easy. So, happy Thanksgiving. Go tell someone who's done something nice for you, thank you, and do something nice for them. That's it, that's all I got. Namaste, I love you guys so much. I hope you have a really, 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 really great holiday.